Everyone, this is me Satya here, and I'm doing your third week of June reading. Start from the 15th through the 21st of June 2020. This is going to be for the sign of Libra. So let's see what's coming up for you guys for this week time. Before I get into the reading, let me remind you, it's a general reading. It may and it may not resonate with everyone out there. So always pick the messages which are resonating with you in your situation and leave the rest. For personal readings, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram, where I do upload daily readings, and you can also check out my sister's tarot channel. I will be adding the link to that in the comment section. If you like it, you can always become a part of her YouTube family as well. So let's see what is heading towards the Libra people for this week time. I will be taking out oracle cards in this and one color card as well to see which color is going to be lucky for you for this week time. So let's get started. Let's see what is heading towards you guys for this week. Let's begin. Starting of the week with the moon. A lot of thoughts creeping in your mind. But all the positive ones. I don't see any negativity here. I feel like, you know, you are seeing some sort of growth or trying to see some sort of positivity, or, you know, it's more like you are trying to look at things from a positive perspective. You're trying to think about solutions, how you can resolve a situation maybe. But yes, you will be pretty much in your head right now as you start of the week, but in a good way. It's not like, you know, baseless or, you know, useless thinking. It's more of a positive way of dealing with things, where you are trying to figure out what can you do to improve your life, to improve the situation, to improve a relationship. It's all positive here. Let's see. Five of Swords. Yes, you are going to come out of this, you know, a period of thoughts, thoughtfulness, with a positive attitude. You are going to find a solution. You are going to figure out what can you do right, what can you do, you know, what can you do to avoid a situation in your life, be that in your love life, work life, home life situation. So it's more like, you know, it's going to empower you. The thought process that you are going through as you start of the week with, it's just like, you know, it has or it will be adding strength to you to deal with the situations in a better way, in a mature way, in a way that it will add happiness to you and to the people involved. So if you have been having any fears, doubts, cloud of cloud or confusions of fears, because caused by fears or doubts, I feel like, you know, you will be kind of, you know, steering clear from that, and you would know that, okay, fine, I need to deal with this in this way, in a, you know, specific way, so I could, you know, have what I want. Let's see more cards. Six of Cups. It could be about a person, about a relationship maybe. And then comes the King of Pentacles. I feel like, you know, it can be about a relationship situation that you might be dealing with. You do have the strength underneath the deck. Hold on. Yeah, so you do have a strength underneath the deck. And underneath that, you do have the Emperor. So I feel like, you know, somebody is definitely finding a way out of, it seems like, you know, somebody has gathered the strength to understand where they were doing things wrong and now ready to make amends so the situation gets better for them in their love life. I feel like, you know, there is somebody that you are missing. There are certain things that you're contemplating on. There are certain things that you are thinking about. There are certain, you know, situations where you are thinking, you're trying to figure out where did you do things wrong. And maybe it's like, you know, you're thinking where your partner did things wrong. But then again, even if you are, you know, blaming them for something wrong that they might have done to you, you are trying to, you know, link or connect all the dots to find out where were you wrong in this whole situation and trying to fix your part of the situation. Because you believe if you fix your part of the situation, the other part of, you know, their part, they are going to fix that, you know, themselves. So I feel like, you know, as you start of the week, as you're trying to figure out how you can take this connection slowly, smoothly, and, you know, happily, same thoughts, your person is also thinking about you and this connection. So I feel like, you know, it's a positive energy that you're starting off the week with. If you have been having any struggles in your relationship with your person, with your husband, with your wife, with your boyfriend, girlfriend, or the person that you love, I feel like, you know, you will be able to find solutions to the current situations, how you can manage things in a right way to have the life that you desire with this person, instead of, like, you know, picking up fights every other day, or, you know, trying not understanding each other for who they are. So it's like, you know, I feel like, you know, there is a positive development within you, which is going to help you take this relationship in a better way. And again, it's coming from mutual, it's coming from both of you. Like, you know, I feel like, you know, you are thinking the same way. You also want to fix things up. They also want to fix things up. And I feel like, you know, for some of you, you might have had a fight with your person. You might have detached from them, or you might have kind of walked away from them, or you might have been, you know, you might have been dealing with certain issues in your love life with your person. But I feel like, you know, during this week time, you are definitely getting some time to think about, you know, how you can resolve the matter, how you can resolve this, you know, situation. It's not gonna be something hard for sure. Neither it's gonna be easy. So it's gonna be like, you know, you will have to, you know, you will have to be very, you will have to think from both perspectives, basically, to actually find a solution to this issue. So yeah, that's what I'm picking up. Let's take more cards in this situation. Let's see what else is going on for you for this, you know, week time in your love life specifically. The Wheel of Fortune paired up with the Emperor. Emperor coming twice. I know that you do have King of Wands. I feel like, you know, there is this issue coming from either one of you. Like, you know, I feel like, you know, one person is either one, obviously, like, you know, if one person is being the one taking care of this connection, then definitely the issue is coming from the other person more than you know, the first person. So I feel like, you know, there is this masculine energy here. Either this is like, you know, I feel like, you know, this masculine energy needs to do something to fix things up. Maybe the other person is too stubborn to fix things up, or maybe you are too stubborn to fix things up. So maybe the person that you are dealing with will have to make the, you know, make things right. When I say masculine energy, it doesn't have to be like, you know, male, you know, have to make the step forward, or, you know, resolve the matter. It can be your person that you are dealing with, even if she is like, you know, a female. That person is a female, but still, maybe she has the masculine energy in her, which is why, like, you know, she wants you to take the step forward. So again, it would be different for different people, but I feel like, you know, one person is putting more effort as compared to the other in this particular connection. But you both feel the same for each other. But yes, I do see there is some sort of ego, or you know, the attitude of, you know, when somebody wants to have a, you know, when somebody wants to have a upper hand in a situation. So I feel like, you know, it can be that for some of you as well. So yeah, let's take Oracle cards now. Let's see what the Oracle has to add to the reading for you guys for this week time. Wow. But yes, I do see you resolving the issues, whatever the issues are. One person is definitely putting more effort, but yes, the issues are going to be resolved for sure, because you do miss each other a lot when you are not talking, when you are apart. It's something that you don't feel right, you know, having that, you know, energy when you are, you know, distant, or, you know, in the fight thing, you know, where you are not talking to each other. You both don't feel right. So definitely you're gonna make efforts. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. Everything is going to get fixed. I feel like, you know, even if you are, you know, not talking to this person and you don't know what's going on, trust me, if you are missing them, they are missing you equally. But yes, there is this ego issue coming from one person. So let's see, what else do we have for you for this week time? My energy creates my reality. What I focus on is what I will manifest. So when you are thinking about certain situations that you might be dealing with in your love life, you have to be very sure about one thing: your energy creates your reality. Even if you have had a fight with the person, if you start thinking that, you know, your person is missing you exactly the way you are missing them, and they also want to fix things up, that's exactly what they will be doing on their part. Like, you know, when you are sitting here, you know, trying to fix things up, they are sitting there trying to fix things up. So your energy is what creates the reality that you are in. So you have to stay very positive. You have to stay very strong. You have to stay motivated enough to find a solution to whatever it is that you're dealing with in your life right now. And definitely, whatever it is that you desire in this particular connection, you know, you can definitely manifest it. You can definitely make it happen. If you are, you know, dealing with a person who is kind of stubborn, but yes, you know that this person is madly in love with you as well, as you know, so you can always go for scripting to make things happen exactly the way you want. Like, if you want this person not to fight with you a lot, not to, argue with you a lot, you can always manifest that by using scripting or using affirmations too. You can also use other manifestation techniques as well, but scripting does magic in this particular situation where, you have pretty much control over everything in your relationship, in your life as well. So I would suggest you to go for that. If you want my assistance, you can check the description box because I do, have scripting technique which is different from the ones available online. So you can either follow the ones online or you can, purchase my scripting technique. It's totally up to you. Both will work for you, but yes, mine is a little bit of more easy and more empowering as well. So it's totally up to you. You want to go for the online ones, you can go for that. But yes, that's gonna help you manifest quicker, manifest in a way where you feel like, okay, fine. Even if this person is like, being stubborn, you can make this person, loosen up the grip on the situation as you like it to be. So just try to manifest it and try to focus it, like, on the things that you want, not on the things that you don't want. And I feel like, you are doing that pretty much already, because I do see you coming out of the thought process with a positive mindset. That shows itself that you are focusing on the things that you want. You really want to manifest this connection, you really want to have a reconciliation, you really want to patch up with this person, and that's what you are manifesting with this person. But for those of you who are dealing with a stubborn kind of a partner, I would suggest you to, use manifestation techniques. It's gonna help you a lot. So let's see what the color card has to add to the reading for you guys for this week time. Let's see which color is going to be lucky for you for this week time. Aqua, number 33, experience peace and calm. You always manifest things that you desire, that you want, by having that peace from within. You really need to calm your inner chatter, the mind chatter, and listen to your inner guidance. And that's how you manifest things. That's how you try to, that's how you find the answers that you are seeking. Exactly what you are doing here in the beginning of the week as well. So do that, experience that peace, and find all the answers that you are seeking right now. And if you feel like, I want to go away from this person and I really don't want this person any longer, when you relax, when you calm down, even if you just had a fight with this person, you are going to realize that no, I really want this person, I really miss this person, I really want to make things right with this person. So again, try to calm yourself down before making any decision or before going mad at this person or going mad at yourself for, doing certain things for to this person or, with this person. Calm yourself down and then figure out what is it that you want. And trust me, you would want this person, nothing else. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for this week time. If the reading resonates with you, do like, subscribe, and share. If you're willing to get a personal reading, you can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box till I do the next reading for you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.